So, dear students, good morning. Today we are going to discuss about natural allergens and allergenic extracts. Before that, first we are going to discuss what is allergy. Allergy is nothing but an untoward immunological reaction towards an immunogen. That immunogen we are saying it as allergens. Very simply, we can say the substance which is going to cause allergy or hypersensitivity reaction in our body, that we are saying it as allergens. Whatever the reactions or hypersensitivity reactions we are observing, that we are saying allergy. During the first exposure, we are going to sensitize the allergens. The second exposure, only the immunological reaction is going to be happen. Usually the allergens will be considered as a proteinous substances, most probably glycoproteins or heteropolysaccharides, which are having the molecular weight of 10,000 to 70,000. This is usually high molecular weight proteins or glycoproteins or heteropolysaccharides. And atopy, that we are saying it is atopy, the another important technical term we should know about is atopy. That is nothing but an inherited tendency to develop common allergies. The example of atopic diseases, which includes allergic rhinitis, allergic asthma, allergic urticaria, are example for atopy. Then we are going to discuss about the types of allergens. Otherwise, we can say it as classification of allergens. One is inhalant allergen, infectant allergen, injectant allergen, contact allergens. These are the important type of allergens. Otherwise, we are saying it as classification of allergens. The different types of allergenic extracts are mentioned here. One is pollen extracts, dust extracts, mold, animal, insect, food, and drug extracts are the important allergenic extracts generally we are using. This pollen extracts, that is the most common one that causes hay fever, that is the most serious symptomatic condition. And the second one is dust extract, that very simple one, the household dust, that is the most common unpollened inhalant allergens. And it's a third, next one is mold extracts, that is the source is mold, that is the major cause of non-pollen atopic allergic reactions. Then animal extracts from the feathers, skin surfaces of birds who has feathers, are the different animal extracts are prepared from the sources. Then insect extracts, hymenoptera, stinging insect, biting insect, different insect parts are also used in the insect extracts. Food extracts, that we are saying it as ingestant allergens. Sometimes some people, they may be allergic towards cow's milk. And drug extracts, common ingestant allergy, that is penicillin. Some people are sense allergic, producing allergic reactions towards penicillin, and tetrazine dye are the most common examples we are generally giving. And then type of allergenic extracts. There is a type of allergenic extracts already we discussed. Next one is preparation of allergenic extracts, which includes the important steps: grinding, defatting, extraction, clarification, dialysis, concentration, sterilization, lyophilization, testing, standardization, and storage. The first one is the collection of sources or raw materials, which may be household dust, or it may be the different parts of, or very few parts of, the insects, are the pollen grains of the different plant species, that may be we are going to use as a raw material. After once we selected the raw materials, then it is subjected to powdering, that we are saying it is grinding process. That is first step. Here the material, whatever the raw material we collected, that is grounded or subdivided in order subdivided into small size particles. That will be useful for the extraction process. Usually for grinding purpose, either we are going to use household blenders or small plant mills our mixer, or while juicers, sometimes we are going to use sometimes for grinding purpose. And materials such as hairs, feathers, textiles should be grinded with the help of finely, should be divided finely with the help of shears. And then after grinding the raw materials, then it is subjected to the process that we are saying defatting process. Usually the allergenic, whatever the raw material it is, we are going to use, generally they are having some fatty, unwanted fatty substances that is going to be removed. The excessive fatty material present in the raw material that is going to be removed with the help of ether or petroleum ether. Generally we are using as a solvent to remove the fatty substances present in this raw material. Usually the defatting provides a clear extract. Also it is used to remove the irritant, any other irritant substances present in the raw materials, that is also going to be removed. For example, coffee, tea, cottonseed, pepper, mustard, ginger, and this some way. These are all the example of the substances going to be removed. The extract obtained from the defatting process may be used in the preparation of some batch testing substances. The next one is extraction process. After the removal of proteins present in this raw material, the defatted substances or raw material should be subjected to extraction process. For the extraction purpose, we are going to use two different solvents, are two different set of solvent system we are going to use. One is buffered saline, another one is coca saline. Buffered saline is composed of sodium chloride, monobasic sodium phosphate, dibasic sodium phosphate, phenol crystals, and water for injection as per USP. That is the formula, it is given here in the table. And then coca solution, it is made up of composed of sodium chloride, phenol crystals, sodium bicarbonate, and water for injection, USP. Mostly either buffered saline or coca solution generally we are using. And extraction duration, how long the raw material should be extracted with either buffered saline or coca saline, usually 24 to 72 hours in a cold room condition with the help of sterile pyrogen free buffered saline we are going to use. And the pH of the mixture is going to be maintained at 8. At the pH of 8, 24 to 72 hours, the raw material, the grinded powdered raw material, which will be treated either with buffered saline or coca solution, that will facilitate the complete extraction of allergenic allergenic extracts. The next one is after the extraction process, next step is clarification. After the extraction, the mixture is clarified by coarse filtration. With the help of coarse filter, we are doing this filtration process. Then the next step is dialysis. Here, the allergenic extracts are dialyzed against saline or running tap water to remove any irritant substance or coloring substances present in that extract that is going to be removed by dialysis process. Mostly the pollens or pollen extracts require no dialysis process, but some substances, example household dust, mustard, potatoes, spinach, beets, that give nearly universally positive reactions unless dialyzed. So the next step is concentration. After dialysis process, during this process, the coloring substances as well as irritant substances can be removed. After that, we are going for this concentration process. Here, the concentration of the extract may be achieved by a number of methods, but care should be taken not to alter the physical nature of the allergenic extracts. Then after concentration, the next step is sterilization process. Here it is sterilized by filtration process. Simple, usually we are saying it is a filtration process, usually through cellulose membrane filter. The concentrated extract is passed through a cellulose membrane filter. This usually pre-filters also we are going to use that is required, but asbestos should not be used since it may absorb some immunogens, and that is allergens, if it may be carcinogenic. Mostly for sterilization purpose, we are going to use only cellulose membrane filter. Very rarely we are using pre-filters also. After sterilization, the another step is lyophilization. Here the freeze-dried pollen extracts are prepared essentially as per the standard procedure. The lyophilized products are reconstituted with buffer saline at the time of usage. The next one is, so these are the method of preparation of allergenic extracts. Then units, what is the units? And the first column, this mentioned the unit, you know, weight per volume. And weight per volume is nothing but allergen, amount of allergen which is present in the particular extract. That is the most common unit of allergenic extract that is used throughout the world. And the second one is PNU, protein nitrogen unit. 1 milligram of protein that is expressed as N contains 1 lakh protein nitrogen containing protein nitrogen unit. That is also another unit generally we are using to express the allergenic extract. Then next one is allergy unit and biological unit. That is the other units of allergenic extracts. And this slide shows that the allergy, different types of allergenic extract. First one is aqueous and glycerinated products. Usually glycerinated means 50% is glycerinated and aqueous allergenic products having the pH of 8. It contains 0.4% as a phenol. Then intradermal extracts, scratch test extracts, therapeutic extracts, autogenous extracts are the different things. The next one is the expiry date of the allergenic extract, whatever you are preparing. Aqueous extract, that is 18 months from the date of manufacture. Glycerinated extract, 3 years from the date of manufacture. Lyophilized extracts are products, 4 years from the date of manufacture. That is the expiry date of the different types of allergenic extracts. The treatment of allergy for the common allergens. But the best thing is avoidance of allergens. That means the patients which are who are all sensitive to animals, pet animals, that they should be keep them a distance or better to avoid the contact of the pet animals and use HEPA filters, high efficiency particular air filters that also used to remove the pollens, mold spores and cat allergens present in the atmospheric air. And second one, using the drugs that we are saying it as pharmacologic therapy. Most common drugs we are using here is cetirizine, chlorpheniramine, promethazine hydrochloride, phenylephrine hydrochloride, that we are saying it as. And most effective method, the third one, is specific immunotherapy. So that was introduced by Norman and Associates. By increasing the dose of allergen for a period of month or year, we can treat the symptoms which are caused by allergens, The first one, the first concentration, 1:500, that is the concentration of allergens should be given or administered to the patients twice a week for 3 months, each dose of 1 ml. And then second one, 1:100, that is the concentration of allergen we are going to use once a week for next 3 months, each dose containing 1 ml, each dose of 1 ml, each dose of 1 ml. Then 1:50, that is the next concentration of allergen that should be administered for once in a month for next 3 months, each dose of 1 ml. If necessary, continue with the last dose, that is 1:50 concentration of allergen once in a month for next 3 months, each dose of 1 ml should be given to treat the allergen symptoms caused by the allergens. Then sensitivity test, mostly we are saying it is intradermal test, prick test or scratch test. These two are the most important one. The intradermal test, most sensitive direct skin test. Here the multiple extracts that can be inspected at one time after 15 minutes to 30 minutes. That is going to produce a wheel and a flare reaction. Usually histamine and diluent controls can be also used to check the sensitivity of the allergenic extracts. Then Prekar's crash test. This is one of the simplest method of checking the sensitivity of allergenic extracts. It is most simpler and safer and less sensitivity than intradermal tests. These are preferred for preliminary screening. Then challenge test. That is here the direct application of extract to the mucous membrane, either bronchial or nasal or ophthalmic. When other tests are impractical or require additional information, that time only we are going to use this challenge test. And last one, there is a patch test that is commonly used for allergenic dermatitis. Here the patches with the material like our bandages, that is going to be the scrub bandages, which is impregnated with the allergenic extracts, that is going to be pasted in our arm. That is going to be removed after 24 to 48 hours. Then we are going to observe any hypersensitivity reactions are happened on the particular surface. Okay, these are the important information related with the